Probably Brother Renee can talk about this more than I could, but I know the Middle Eastern culture, it was unheard of for any type of woman to run up into a group of men and express anything. In the Middle East culture right now, the women will keep their faces and their bodies, you might see them from here, but they don't run. It was unheard of for them to speak. Even in Paul's writing, he said, if the women have anything to say, let them get home with their husbands and ask their husbands. They wasn't to speak during the services. Now, I know the women's rights has come a long way. It wasn't too long in this country, in the United States of America, Sister Mary, that a woman never even had the right to vote. Probably your grandmother or your great-grandmother, some of you never even had the right to vote. But we've come a long way. Thanks the good Lord for that. In fact, I look for the day, Sister Mary, when we have a woman sitting on the board of directors here. Amen? Watch out. I get a backlash right there. But Sister Mary, we got to press through some obstacles sometimes. We got to be willing to go through to get to there. This woman was so desperate that she ran up and done something that was unheard of. And she began to call out to the Lord and said, Lord, have mercy upon me, thou son of David. I want to kind of cut loose a lot of things. I feel I need to do this right now. You just picture you're going to Pastor Benny's church. Somebody you look up to. I'll use him as an example because we're here in his church this morning. You just picture you're going to Pastor Benny, somebody you love and you look up to, and you go over and you try to talk to him, then he ignores you. You got a desperate need, and he ignores you completely. And then the people in his church says, you're not of our kind. You don't look like us. You don't dress like us. You don't sound like us. Why don't you better off going down the road somewhere? Huh? Now, it's easy when people's welcoming you. They'll welcome you in, pat you on the back to come in and worship God. But let them ignore you. Let them not speak to you. Let them tell you to leave and see what you'll do. Do you think you'd have any folks visit you with that kind of attitude in your church? That's what this little woman was faced with. But it didn't stop her from getting to what she needed. Everything that Jesus answered her back with, you know, everything she answered Jesus back with, was she was answering him right. When he looked at her and he said to her, I'm not sent but to the Gentiles. Truth, Lord. But then it says she worshiped him. She began to probably bow down. I love you, Jesus. Lord, I love you, Lord. See, she wasn't there for herself. She was there for her child. She was there for her daughter. Now, some of you may understand what I'm talking about here now. How many mothers that's here this morning just woke up at 3 o'clock in the morning and you fell on your face before God because you knew that one wasn't home yet? You know they was out on the road somewhere and you felt you begin to cry and call upon the name of the Lord. See, there's something in a mother's heart towards that child. This woman didn't care what she had to do. She was pressing in to the Lord. She apparently heard about Jesus. She knew the power that he had from other illustration miracles that he had done. But when she got there, she ran right into the middle of him and said, Lord, help me. Have mercy upon me. She called him mercy. Mercy is a word that moves the Lord. She didn't even know what she was saying. She was seeing mercy in the flesh. He was mercy. If you'd seen him hanging on a cross 2,000 years ago, that was mercy hanging in the flesh there. She was talking to mercy. One time, Moses had left the people and went up on the mountain to talk to God. And God said, you better go back down there. You better go back down there to him. He left the flock to the assistant pastor. And the assistant pastor came in and they didn't build a big golden calf. And he went down and God said, you go back down there. And when he got back down there, Moses knew he was a God of mercy because God said, Moses, I'm just going to go ahead and kill them all and wipe them all out and raise up a people unto you. Well, I'm going to tell you something. There's some arrogant people that I know of. to move the hands of God. Y'all's awful quiet in here today.
That's good.
Romans 9, Paul said, God said, I will have mercy on who I will have mercy on. The disciples wanted to run her off, send her away. Jesus ignored her, but she still worshiped him. We're talking about what moves God. Anyone can praise him in good times. But you see, I found this out through my walk with God and through reading this. In the beginning of creation, God created angels in heaven. Ever how many years ago, in the beginning of time, millions of years, a thousand years, whatever it was. And the Bible says they rest not. And all they do right now around the throne is saying, holy, 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 God Almighty, which was and which is to come. It says they rest not doing that. But you see, apparently, that's not what satisfied God. And I believe that's why he created you and me. He didn't want to create something that was programmed like that little bunny rabbit running back and forth. He didn't want somebody to praise him and worship him because they had to. He wants somebody here today to praise and worship him and love him because they want to from the bottom of their heart. And that's what moves the Lord. It's wonderful to have a great musicians and talent like this here to lead you into worship. But I'm telling you, God wants somebody. What are you going to do when they're not there? What do you want to do when there's not somebody there to lift you up in the name of the Lord like this beautiful young lady sent to some of the anchor holes and you can feel the anointing upon that? You've got to be able to get through to the Lord for yourself. You can't point the finger and say, it's somebody else's fault because we made choices that God is that way. It's not my brother, it's not my sister, but it's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of help here today. This woman